Have a pleasant afternoon, everyone. Hi, I'm Cedric C. Ribeiro from Bachelor of Secondary Education, majoring in English. And this afternoon, I'm going to report basic skills in playing basketball. So just sit there, stand by, open up your mind, let my voice be heard, and together, let's learn. Basketball is one of the world's most basic games, with the goal of putting the ball into the net hoop more times than the opposing team. So the method by which a person or group does this, however, it is far more difficult than it appears at first look. Shooting, dribbling, defending, rebounding, and passing are among the most significant abilities in the game of basketball that later on I will discuss and then to be continued by Ma'am Kayla Corpus. Aside from this, basketball's specific talents, agility, acrobatic ability, speed, and endurance are all valuable assets in the game. For instance, without the capacity to jump, one cannot be excellent at rebounding or defending. Just as a player who is not the fastest will probably not be as strong at defense as somebody who is. Each basketball attribute can be improved, and the strategies is used to do so outweigh the game's primary skills by a factor of 100. At all stages of the sport, practices and strategies are utilized to instruct the game properly and develop better players. So now let's start about the dribbling. So dribbling is the act of moving the ball across the floor by a player. So if a player walks around the court with the ball, it's considered a traveling violation. So here's the dribbling tips. So the first one, do not dribble with the palm of your hands but your fingers instead. And then practice dribbling hard or doing pound dribbles. And then another thing that you must have or you must do is to spread your fingers wide for a better ball support. And also you must practice dribbling practice dribbling with your off hand rather. If you're right-handed, do dribbling drills with your left hand as well. So look for techniques on how you can have a quick dribble. Having a quick dribble will also allow you to get to your support quicker than the defense. Now that we already know what is a dribble and what are the tips on dribble, let's now take a moment and tackle about the defense. So the aim of a defense is to stop the opposing team from getting good shooting and scoring opportunities. So a team may never beat a basketball game if they don't play excellent defense. Thus, it is a quality that everyone should acquire. So here's the tips for the defense. So for your arm's length, so do not begin too close or too far away from the offense. If you are too close, they will drive by you. If you are too far, they will shoot. The best thing is to begin at least an arm's length away, like this. Arm's length away, just spread your arms. So it is appropriate to reach out to your defender if you are not sure whether you are far enough away. And then another thing, so you must keep your step short. Never forget your footwork. Taking long steps often will hinder your progress while defending drives. So take a shorter, choppier steps and remember to push ball off your front foot. So another key is to have an active hands. While on the ball, your hands are busy. but you must also remember to use your hands while defending the penetration. Use a deflection hand, high and a ball hand. Low and up your defender. A lot of coaches will call this riding a player out. While you are defending the drive, try to poke the ball out with your ball hand and then use your deflection hands to block passes or quick shots. So that was the end of my discussion for today. So the next tips for the basketball will be discussed by our next reporter, Ma'am Kayla Corpus. So that's all. I hope you gain something about my discussion. Thank you and bye.